Greetings, conference. Today, I will present the topic of applying ETAP to calculate and analyze BASS installation in Vietnam Power System. The contents of the presentation will include three parts. Part one is an overview of Vietnam Power System. Part two is about the BASS installation calculation and analysis for Vietnam Northern Power System. Part three focuses on the BASS installation calculation and analysis for Vietnam South Central Power System. Vietnam's power system has been divided into three regions. North, from the north to Hà Tĩnh province, about 25 provinces. Central region province, from Quảng Bình to Đắk Nông, Khánh Hòa, about 19 provinces. South province, from Ninh Thuận, Lâm Đồng, to the end of the south, about 19 provinces. Current status of transmission grid includes 36,500 kV stations and 175,220 kV stations. The total length of the 500 kV transmission lines is about 9,000 kilometers. The total length of the 220 kV transmission line is about 18,000 kilometers. Current status of electricity consumption of the whole Vietnam power system for 2021, with a PMAX of about 43 gigawatts, an increase of about 13% compared to 2020. Commercial electricity is about 255 billion kilowatt hour, up 4% compared to 2020. Status of power source by 2021, the total installed capacity of the national power source is 76 gigawatts. And the production power is 256 gigawatt hour, in which the proportion of capacity of renewable energy sources include solar power, wind power, hydroelectricity, account for about 27% of the national power source. The rate increase significantly after having policies to encourage energy development in recent years. The chain of inter-regional transmission of Vietnam's power system record in 2021 is mainly from north to central and central to south. North to central transmission is about 4 billion kilowatt hour in 2021. And the inter-central south transmission is about 11 billion kilowatt hour in 2021. Regarding import and export of electric energy, we import from China, from Laos, and we export to Cambodia. Vietnam power system has met some challenges in recent years. The transmission line between north and central is only about 2.5 gigawatts, which is lower than the actual need. In the central region, The capacity is surplus and sometimes having curtailment. In the south central region, overloading of transmission lines or transformers in the area where renewable energy sources are concentrated, the overloading trend will increase when explore the potential renewable power source in South Central, lead to the need to simulate Vietnam power system with many scenarios to propose solution. Modeling the 500 kV and 220 kV power system in Vietnam by using ETAP software. Use the 3D database filter to set up load change profile corresponding to four typical scenarios in operating in Vietnam power system: maximum load, minimum load, dry and rainy season. As shown on the slide for maximum load scenarios, low voltage is shown in red, and in the minimum load mode, the voltage shown in the rainy season shown by the blue arrows. Part 2 is about the BESS insulation calculation analysis for Vietnam Northern Power System. Challenges of the Northern Grid are the structure of power source of the Northern Power System shows that hydropower source account for 50%. Thermal power source account for about 49%. The power source mainly depends on the ability to mobilize hydroelectricity and thermal power. So in the dry season, when the weather is hot, the mobilization of hydroelectricity causes difficulties in operation. At the same time, the power load on dry season is higher than normal. At the end of May 2021, the load in the north suddenly peaked above 21 gigawatts, up 5% over the same period in 2020. The mobilization of internal source in the north is not enough to meet the load at this time. The typical daily load graph in the dry season shows that in 2022, the north is likely to lack peak capacity in the time frame 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. and 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. Load projection and national power and grid development plans up to 2025 show that this peak capacity shortfall will increase even further until 2025. The BESS application, as we know, it includes peak saving, spinning reserve, load leveling, frequency regulation, voltage support, capacity firming. After analyzing the options and solutions to meet the negative for peak days in the dry season of the Northern Power System, we come up with a solution to install BESS with peak saving application to solve the problem of peak hour coverage. Proposing the option of installing distributed BESS at 22 kV bus bar of 110 kV substation to discharge BESS in off-peak hours and discharge energy in peak hours. Modeling the Northern Power Grid using model time domain load flow with the source and load data collected from June 23rd, 2020 to calculate the typical one-day peak capacity flows in the right season and observe the elements of the power grid. On data file of 500 kV, 220 kV filters and power plants generation charts in Excel are collected with real data from the National Dispatch Center, then imported into ETEP to run time domain load flow. In addition, the load chart of 110 kV substations is statically given the typical chart as follows: typical industrial load, typical load for residential area, typical load for commercial service. Some loads will combine typical loads with each other. For example, 7% of commercial service and 30% of apartment loads to match the type of load chart corresponding to the characteristics of the project area. After running time domain load flow for Northern Power System, we have the result. We can see from the summarized table of malfunctioning elements in normal operation mode, it is found that the areas with a large number of overload elements are mainly located in the inner city of Hà Nội and Thái Nguyên, Bắc Ninh, Hải Phòng, Quảng Ninh. In the period up to 2025, work to improve and increase capacity together with new construction of regional lines. Anticipation will reduce the load on existing lines. However, with the growth rate of load in the northern province, the regional power system appear overload on 110 kV transmission line in province with high concentration of load such as Hà Nội, Quảng Ninh, Thái Nguyên, and Nam Định. Proposed BESS insulation location are location with overload and full load transmission line or transformer in normal operation in the period 2021 to 2025. At this location, it is reported to implement additional BESS unit with gradually increasing computing power until there are no more overload and full load transmission line or transformer in normal operation in parallel 2021 to 2025. The capacity is determined from the area of intersection between the power curve passing through the magnetic path and the rating of the device as shown in the figure. Calculation results of possible locations. Capacity to install BESS on Northern Power System. Thái Nguyên Province has the largest installed capacity of BESS, about 180 megawatts. Thái Nguyên and Hải Phòng Province have the largest installed capacity of BESS, 400 megawatt hour. By 2025, Quảng Ninh Province needs to add the largest amount of capacity to peak saving, 160 megawatt. Quảng Ninh Province needs to add the largest BESS capacity, 600 megawatt hour. Time domain load flow test results after installing BESS, the regional power grid ensure reliable, safe operation in normal operation mode. Part 3 focuses on the BESS installation, calculation, and analysis for Vietnam South Central Power System. The total power source in the South Central region is about 14 gigawatts, with the structure including thermal power about 31%, hydroelectricity about 21%, farm solar power more than 28%, rooftop solar power about 10%, wind power about 7%. Total capacity of renewable energy source accounts for 46%. With concentrated power source and maximum generation at low load hours, overloading regional grid elements in Ninh Thuận Province include 110 kV Tháp Chàm to Ninh Phước transmission line, 110 kV Tháp Chàm to Đa Nhiêm transmission line, 110 kV Phan Rí to Phú Lạc transmission line. And in Bình Thuận Province, there are two transmission lines overload, 110 kV Phan Thiết to Mũi Né, 110 kV Phan Thiết to Sơn Mỹ. Modeling of the South Central Power System and time domain load flow by typical day. We propose BESS installation locations are locations with overload and full load transmission line or transformer in normal operation in the period 2021 to 2025. At this location, additional BESS units with gradually increasing power until there are no overload transmission line or transformer in normal operation in the period 2021 to 2025. The BESS capacity is roughly determined from the area of intersection by the power curve passing through the rating limit. The rating of the device as shown in the figure. Time domain log flow test result after installing BESS. The regional power grid ensure reliable safe operation in normal operation mode. Thank you for your attention.